So hello and welcome back to Test Drive Thursday. As you can see, today we're looking at the DAF 105. So this is basically a tuning mod for this truck. It's quite in depth, as I'll show you very shortly. But firstly, I do apologise for the sort of lag when choosing the options. I'm not sure what's causing that. I've disabled some mods, but I think it may be this mod itself doing that, but I'm not sure. That doesn't happen very often. But let's head over into the upgrade shop and I'll show you. So I'll only be looking at the upgrades in this episode. We'll take a look at the driving next episode, but so far you can see all the detail on the glass and everything, and the audio is pretty good, but as I said, we'll get into that in the next video. So let's head over here and take a look at the options. So upgrade shop, and here we are. So there's lots of cabins to choose from, starting from the starting from the comfort cabin. Very sort of boxy design, as you can see. So if you're taking maybe heavy hauls, that could be useful. Maybe like a lower trailer, that might be quite good. You've got the spoiler, then space cab with or without spoiler, and then you've got the aero piece around the back. Then you get to the larger piece, but this time without the sort of cutouts, these style lights. Then you've got them with, which in my opinion looks a lot better. Then you've also got the long line, which I've never seen before in a DAF. I mean, just look at it back there. You got like, let's just get inside for a sec. Oh, we're in the back. So you've got, okay, that's a bit weird. Again, I can't get back out, which always seems to be a bug. That looks like a bed, but in my opinion, that looks a bit too short to be a bed. And this looks like a bed as well, and then you've got a table. So that's an interesting little thing. But I think that's it. So then you get to the chassis. Now, with the long line, the 4x2 does look a bit weird. But then you can lower it, you can pimp it out and everything. Yeah, you can hire it, lower it. It's kind of cool, really. Long line cabin version. Guess that. What does that do? I'd guess it moves the fifth wheel, but doesn't look like it. Yeah, a lot of variety here, all with raised, lowered, and everything. X-Y-2s, X-Y-2-4s, different style tanks. Probably better showing you this side. But yeah, just look at the variety. You can just pick for absolute days. I'm not going to go through everything. You can then have these boxes and everything. Like that. 6x2 ML. I've never seen that before. I mean, it's just great variety. It really is. Just look at this. Long line versions. I don't think there's like any 8x4s, which I think would have been nice to see, but yeah, there's quite a few options, as you can see. I'll just go for let's just go for that one for now whilst we're choosing. Then you get to the engines. Now, as you can see, there's two different sound versions, version 1 and version 2. Now, as I said, we'll get into that in the next episode. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave discussing all the engines until the next episode, because honestly, even if I had time to record this in all in one go, I think it would be a really long video. So it's probably a good thing that I'm splitting it in two. But as you can see, you get the engine designation on the side, which is a nice little add-on. You don't see that often working. So transmission, 12 speed, 6 speeds, pretty standard stuff really. Now on the interior, so you got the standard, which is this black with the sort of fabric and whitish seats with the cream leather on the dash, and then the sort of brown up here, which in my opinion doesn't really match, and that table looks extremely high if you look at it in relation to the seat. It's a bit weird, isn't it? So yeah, that interior is a bit rubbish. Then got this, which in my opinion it's probably the best one, with the wood. As you can see, it's usually it has a sort of drive. Hang on, if we just pick one. Well, it usually has like a drive neutral reverse thing here for the automatic gearbox, but it's got a manual stick there, which is a nice detail. So with this you get the sort of white beds, the grey seats. Oh no, it's flicked me around. Probably best to show you here actually. Then the grey up here, and in my opinion it looks a lot better. You do get the sort of person who did it on there, which I don't like, but there you go. So with this one, brown and grey seat pattern, cream up here, black roof. Again, I just find some of them a bit weird. And you get the plus, which is absolutely horrible. Yellow, white, brown, and some form of grey. It is... ugh. And you can also have the UK. And look at it on the dash as well, on the dials. That is absolutely horrible. It really is. Loads of skins here, all the standard SCS ones as you would expect, but we just go for white now whilst we're configuring. Now this is where I apologise for the lag for some reason when picking the options. But down here you can have a variety of little spoilers, as they're called down here. Chrome, paint, a lot of variety there for you to choose from, but in my opinion it just doesn't look right. I much prefer it like that, it's a lot cleaner. Mud flaps, general variety down here, like that. And you've got lower grille guards, so this is the standard lower grille guards down there, which look a lot better than the sort of customised mod ones. This one, fog lamps, as you can see now, they're completely blocked out. But you can go with, as I said, a variety of them, with daytime running lights if that's what you want on your DAF, or anything you want really. I mean, look at these LEDs up here. I mean, just the detail they've gone to is absolutely superb. See here, you can completely change the front of the truck to any sort of style that you want. If you want to make it a workhorse truck, or if you want to go for a full-on show truck or heavy haul. I mean, look at that. That is a bit, it's a bit in your face, that. I'm not sure about that. But anything you want, mate, really. Look at that. Even that's a bit weird. I'm not sure why anyone would want it like that. But there you go. You can have it exactly to your taste. Convoy plate, so many dots you don't know what to do with them. And then you can change the drop something on the floor, so you can change the colour of the sort of grill down here. You can change everything about it, I mean the outside, the inside, and just again to anything you want. I mean, just look at that. Very blingy, and I can't see what dot I'm on. There we go. So these are the headlights. Again, you can change these. You want them yellow, you can have them yellow. If you want them tinted, you can have them like that. You can completely change the design of them if you want. I mean, let's look at that. It's just amazing what you can do with this mod. In my opinion, they look a lot more realistic, just the sort of bloom on them, so I'll probably go for them. Up here, this is, oh, look at that, right down to the detail of the slats on the grill. That's really good. And then yeah, look at that in here, I've never even noticed that before. And you can even have lights inside it like that. That is great. Really good. Right, there's just so many dots, you don't know what to do with them. Then you can also have them paint if you want. Which actually fills them in, if you have them paint. Whereas here, you've got some kind of venting, which actually isn't going anywhere. So, up here, I guess this is changing this grill. Yeah, look at that. There you go. And then you've got side reflectors in any colour that you want. Change the top colour. What's big red mean? Oh, look at that. That's a bit weird. There are some weird options I've noticed. I mean, not sure why anyone would go with that. There you go. In the DAF logo, you can change that to red if you want for some reason. Convoy plate again. Mirrors, standard stuff, but this time you can have them all in paint if you want, even the arms. Gotta be careful not to go for the interior options now. So, window surrounds, sort of handles for cleaning the window. Right, I guess this is the, yeah, sun visors. They're all standard, so I'm not going to go through them. But yeah, as I said, most of these are the front mud guards. Oh, in fact, no, some of these are front wing. Look at that. Catwalks. I don't know what that is. Ah, these. Oh, okay. There you go. I mean, you've got to be careful. Some of these that you're going to miss. Hero 5 on the side. Truck of the year 2007. 10 years ago. Stock long. What's that? Front mirror. Ah, here. But yeah, just... There's too many dots. Honestly, there are too many dots to choose between. I mean, half of these are missing. I mean, look at that. Aftermarket blinkers. What on earth? Red fuel tanks. There you go. There's your red fuel tanks. If you wanted them. Down the side, I'm guessing these are exhausts. Oh, that doesn't work. And then a variety of side skirts options with, you can have scan your side lights if you wanted. Don't know why you would want to on your DAF, but there you go. Air intakes, any colour that you want. Hose rack you can't do anything with. Spoiler. The spoiler arms you can change the colour of and then add a fire extinguisher. It's a bit red that. And then, but yeah, it is amazing, the detail of this mod. I'm not sure why the obsession with red is here. Look at that. I do prefer those lights so much compared to these. Partly because these are a bit low res, but just look at that. So much better. That looks like an MAN actually. Rear lights, new LED chrome. Wow. So many options. I haven't even done up here yet. Roof sign. Over here, interior mirror wood. Okay, so you can add a mirror inside your truck. I've never seen that before. Even the lights up here, you can tint and change. Wow. Halogen lamps, or xenon lamps, samurai paint. Oh, you can have painted light bars. That is great. Any truck mod that has painted light bars is a good mod. Air horns. I'm guessing this is aircon unit. Yep. Roof hatch. You can have a glass one if you want. Does that work inside? Let me have a look. No, it doesn't work inside. So what's the point of a glass if you can't see it? Then bonfire. But yeah, that's pretty much it, I think. I'll probably miss a few things, but we'll go on to the interior. Which I don't know how mad it's going to be in here. I hate that wheel. I really do. Three spoke. Why do people want a wheel like that in their truck? Oh my gosh. These are horrible. I'll just go for the black one. I'm guessing this is the sat-nav. There we go, sat-nav. Aftermarket stereo. Looks a bit rubbish, really, if you ask me. Look at that. Ooh, right. Bluetooth adapter. Only if these work properly, then I'll probably put them on. What on earth? Green? To match with what? The brown? This is weird. There's loads of stuff, but what's here is quite... Oh my gosh. Facts, that may work with the wood. Let's go standard plus. And then let's go for... Where is it? Dash styling kit. In fact, it doesn't work completely, does it? Because there's a gap. Oh my. Is it like a grey one? Oh, this is... Ugh. Here we go, grey one. It just doesn't look right, in my opinion. Just that gap of wood would drive me insane. Dash... Oh dear. Custom dashboard slots, what the heck? So you could have a pot of gold right in front of you. You could have, I don't know, Michelin man right in front of your view. You could have a sandwich down there. Oh, what a great thing that would be. Right in front of you. This mod. Honestly, what is up with this mod? In fact, look at that. The driver has changed. That's not a standard driver. Engine cover type? That's not an engine cover. I know the engine's below, but what on earth? Seat covers. Oh dear. They look rubbish. I'll keep with the standard curtains. Please don't be pink or something stupid. In fact, the grey ones aren't so bad. Window stickers. Oh dear, this mod. I mean, I don't even have time to go through all of them. I'd be here all day. Antenna, look at that. Some protective position. Oh, this, look at that. The Ravens, that. What a great driving position that is. Oh, that is perfect. Look at that. I've got to do a challenge with this. Cover all of this in Ravens. Have this all the way down. Oh, what a good thing that would be. Window stickers everywhere. Plastic. Flags. That's the dashboard. Stone guard. There you go, stone guard. Light boxes, what's that? What on earth is that? I don't even know, there's some cables going everywhere. Holland Trucking. I've never seen that before. Does that light up? Don't know. Let me just check if it lights up. Yeah, it does, look at that. You do get cables going everywhere though, but I like the detail with the cables running everywhere. As I said, I like the mod, but some of the bits that you get on it are a bit weird. But I think that's pretty much it. The rest of it's pretty standard stuff. CB radio. And those spotlights up there, oh my gosh. Side curtains, bed curtains, oh dear. And that's the mirror that I was on about. I don't think there's anything else apart from the aircon unit. But yeah, that is this mod. There's lots to it, and there's lots of stuff to add and change. But I'll leave that to you, I think, to have a mess around with. But again, thank you for watching. If you did enjoy it and want to see what it's like to drive this truck, please do stay around until next week. But again, thank you for watching. Please click like and subscribe if you're not already. And goodbye.